Hello everyone. Okay, now I continue our transition element topic. Okay, now I go through the general properties of transition element. But today I will focus on chemical properties of relative stability, okay, and variable oxidation state. Alright, now here is the general properties of transition element. Okay, so the first one is the higher melting point and boiling point. Okay, the second one is transition element is a higher density. Okay, and then it will exhibit variable oxidation states. Okay, and then transition element can form complex, form colored compound, and show catalytic properties. Okay. Okay, now, okay, here is the topic of variable oxidation state. Okay, actually all the transition metal, okay, from titanium to copper exhibit two or more oxidation state in their compound. Okay, why? Okay, this is because the small energy difference between 3D and 4S subshell enable the electrons from 4S as well as variable number of electrons from 3D subshell to be involved in bonding. Okay, so they have many outer electron in 3D and 4S, okay, orbital, okay, to be involved in the bonding. So it depends how many electron it has. Okay, so according to this table, okay, from scandium, okay, to zinc, okay, if you can see that for scandium it only have one oxidation state, which is 3. Okay, while zinc is only have 2. So that shows scandium and zinc is not a part of transition element. Right. Then, okay. For this one is okay, starting for titanium anti-copper, here is the maximum oxidation state. Right? And maximum oxidation state belong to each element. Right. Okay, and then okay, this maximum oxidation state corresponds to the maximum number of electrons available in 4S and 3D subshell for bonding. Okay, then this refer electrons in 4S and 3D. 3D is we refer to the uncapped electron only. So the total we get the maximum oxidation state. Okay, I'll show you the example here. Alright. So I use iron. Iron, okay, it have 3d6 and 4s2. Okay, here is the valence electronic configuration of iron, which is 3d6, okay, and 4s2. Alright, how to calculate the maximum oxidation state of transition element? Alright, so okay, we take a look for the unpaired electron in 3d orbital and the electron in the 4s orbital. So electron, this electron, okay, this electron available for chemical reaction. Okay, so we can calculate this electrons, okay, to show the maximum oxidation number of each element. Okay, now, okay, how to calculate? Okay, four electron here. Okay, four electron in four unpaired electron in 3d orbital. Okay, when we plus to the 2 electron in 4s, total number is 6. Okay, so we get 6. So 6 electron is referred to the maximum oxidation state of iron. Alright? Okay. Okay, here is the orbital diagram. Okay, it shows the electron arrangement for each transition element. Alright. Okay, so from this orbital diagram, actually we can determine the oxidation state that occur for each element. Alright, okay. Okay, actually from this diagram, okay, we can see that they have also scandium and zinc. And we know that these both are not a part of transition element. Okay, so it only have one oxidation state. Okay, so okay, according to the 3D orbital and 4S orbital. Okay, so it consists of 1, 2 and 3. Okay, it consists of 3 only. So that's why for a scandium, it only have positive 3 oxidation state. Okay, why for zinc?
Okay, zinc only use its valence electron, which is K2 oxidation state. Okay, for transition element, okay, I want you to take a note for chromium. Okay, chromium here and also copper here because it's different. Okay, calculation is quite different from the others. Okay, now we continue to the titanium. Okay, titanium at 4s orbital it have 2, so means that the oxidation state is starting from 2. Okay, followed by 3 and 4 here. So oxidation state of titanium is positive 2 until positive 4 oxidation state. Okay, for vanadium. Okay, vanadium also have 2. Okay, in valence, so it's starting by 2, okay, until, okay, 2, 3, 4, and 5 here. So, it's, okay, oxidation state of vanadium, until positive 5. Alright, okay, chromium. Okay, chromium, okay, because of actually its stability is higher in this kind of diagram. Okay, but in formation of oxidation state, we must refer to the less stable configuration of chromium. So basically, for s orbital, it consists of 2 electrons. So chromium starting, okay, from 2 oxidation state, okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So okay, so oxidation state for chromium is from 2 to 6 oxidation state. Alright, okay, and then manganese. Okay, manganese is the highest oxidation number, which is 7, because it consists of the most unpacked electron in 3D orbital. Okay, so for manganese, okay, it's starting from 2 also. Okay, so 2 here. Okay, until. Okay, until 2, okay, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So, okay, so for manganese, it's from 2 until 7 oxidation state. Alright, okay, and then followed by iron. Iron, okay, so 2 here. Okay, so oxidation state of iron starting from 2, okay, until, okay. Okay, until 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, 2 until 6. Alright, so remember that we only calculate the unpaired electron in the 3D orbital. Okay, cobalt. Cobalt, okay, also 2 in S orbital. So, 2 until 3, 4, and 5. So oxidation state of cobalt is from 2 until 5 oxidation number. Okay, nickel. Okay, nickel starting from 2 also. Okay, until 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so until 4 oxidation state. Alright, okay, finally copper. Okay, copper. Okay, copper is okay, also same. So actually, is copper from its calculation. Okay, so copper have a exception here, which is for oxidation state for copper, we calculate the one electron in the 4s orbital. Okay, so for copper only, it have positive one oxidation state. Alright, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, 1 until 3. Okay, so that's why I said earlier that chromium, okay, and copper have different calculation in determine the oxidation state. So this all the oxidation state number that you must memorize. Okay. Okay, here is the table of ion which shows the different oxidation state for each element. Alright, okay, now if you can see from the notes, okay, lower oxidation state, okay, which is 1 positive 1, positive 2 and positive 3, okay, are exist as a simple ion. Okay, example, okay, for titanium 2+, titanium 3+, okay, vanadium 2+, and vanadium 3+, okay, manganese 2+, manganese 3+, okay, and then followed by, okay, copper plus and copper 2+. Okay, this is all the simple ion. This is for higher oxidation state, which is from positive 4 to positive 7, okay, it's bonded covalently to electronegative element like oxygen, chlorine, okay, forming ozo ions. Okay, so for more than 4 oxidation state, okay, all the transition element are exist as a ozo ion. Alright, so this ozo ion is formed, okay, why? Okay, so because of the higher charge density of transition element, okay, which is we know that transition element has smaller size and higher charge. So make it higher charge density, so it's tendency to covalently bonded with higher electronegativity element like oxygen. Alright, so that's why if you can see for titanium, okay, it exists as a TiO2+, okay, or the vanadium, okay, here is Po2+, Po2+, and Bo3-, okay, and then for chromium we have chromate here, we have bichromate, okay, and then for manganese, okay, so it have manganate, okay, it have permanganate, and also for iron it have ferret. Okay, so this is we call as a ozo ion. Okay, now, alright, so from the ozo ion, okay, so we can calculate the oxidation state in the ozo ion. Okay, example, for titanium, okay, this is how we calculate the oxidation state from the given ozo ion. So titanium plus oxygen negative 2, okay, equal to positive 2 here for the compound charge, okay, and the titanium equal to positive 4, so this is the positive 4. Alright, okay, and then we take a look for other compound. Okay, we take a look for other ozo ion, okay, Bo2+, so vanadium, okay, totally it will form positive 4 oxidation state. Okay, and then the second one for vanadium is Bo2+ charge. Okay, so when we calculate, okay, we will get vanadium as a positive for oxidation state. Okay, and then, okay, Bo3-, okay, when we calculate it, okay, like this, so we will get positive 5 oxidation state. Right, so this is how we calculate. Okay, another example is, okay, we take a look for chromium, for chromate. Okay, for this is the chromate. Okay, so this is how we calculate it lah. Alright, and then finally we get chromium positive 6. Right, and then dichromate. Okay, how about dichromate? Chromate is also same. Okay, when we calculate it, okay, we get positive 6 oxidation state. Okay, this is the positive 6 oxidation state for chromium. Okay, next example. Okay, for manganese. Okay, for manganese here. Okay, okay, for manganese here, MnO42-. Okay, what is the oxidation number of manganese in this ozo ion? Okay, we get positive 6. Okay, and then, okay, here, so actually it's here. Okay, for manganese here. Okay, so we get positive 7. Okay, which is only manganese contain the highest oxidation state, which is positive 7. Okay, then, okay, for ferret, okay, we can calculate for iron oxidation state in ferret. Alright, so we get positive 6. Okay, next. Okay, here is the table that shows the reaction of transition metal to oxygen. Okay, if you can see that the most oxidation transition metal, Okay, we react with oxygen to form oxides. Alright, and this oxide nearly all insoluble in water. Okay, due to the covalent character. Alright, like I said before. Okay, because of the higher charge density. Right? Okay, the most important in this table that you must know is, right, okay, mostly all the oxide form of the transition element is covalent character. Okay, when covalent character means that it's insoluble in water. Alright, okay, another important thing is the low oxidation state, which is positive 2 and positive 3, okay, mostly form basic oxide. Okay, basic electrovalent oxide. Okay, example, okay, MnO, Mn2O3 compound. Okay, this both compound is a positive 2 and positive 3 oxidation state. So, it is a basic oxide. Okay, why? For the higher oxidation state, okay, like positive 4, 5, 6, and 7, okay, here is, okay, we form acidic covalent oxide. For example, Mn2O7, which is, it is acidic. Right.